Hello everyone, I am Dr. Jay Mehta from Shri IVF Clinic in Mumbai, and today I am here to clear the misconceptions and the unreasonable statements which people pass about IVF or in vitro fertilization. Remember, logo ka kaam hai kehna, but logo ke kehne se ya logo ke na kehne se aap pregnant nahi hone wale. It's very important that as a couple you understand the important things regarding this treatment and then make an informed decision so that you get the desired result and the desired happiness which you've been long waiting for. IVF is in vitro fertilization. Basically, this is a technique of assisted reproduction where the sperms and the oocytes or the eggs are kept in a petri dish. Following this and after a period of incubation, the sperms would go and fertilize the oocyte. Here, it is actually nature who selects the best quality of the sperm in order to fertilize that particular oocyte. Following fertilization, what happens is growth, and this growth results in the formation of an embryo. In common terms, this is a baby. However, this is a small size baby. These embryos are allowed to grow either till day 3 or till the 5th day, following which these embryos will be put back inside the uterus of the intended mother. ICSI basically stands for intracytoplasmic sperm injection. This is another sub-branch or another sub-specialized technique in assisted reproduction. What is done here is that the embryologist or the biologist would handpick or would select the best sperm, would insert this selected sperm manually inside the egg or the oocyte. Following this insertion, fusion occurs, following which there is division, which gives rise to the formation of an embryo. This embryo is then allowed to be cultured till the 3rd day or till the 5th day, following which it is transferred inside the uterus of the intended mother. Depending on the sperm parameters, the embryologist and the clinician would take a decision as to IVF or ICSI would benefit the patient more. It is important to note broadly that when the sperm parameters are in the normal range and the age criteria permit, the decision is taken more in favor of performing the IVF. However, when the sperm count is on the lower end of the spectrum, along with poor motility parameters, that's usually the time when the clinician and the biologist or the embryologist would opt for ICSI, because it is believed that in such sperm parameters, ICSI is supposed to ensure better fertilization rates as against the natural selection via IVF. We've already understood the difference between ICSI and IVF, but it is important to note that on a broad spectrum of disease, ICSI is chosen when there is intended male infertility. That means when male parameters or sperm parameters are not supportive enough to allow natural fertilization. Because, as explained before, in ICSI, the biologist or the embryologist can handpick the best sperms and fuse them manually with the oocytes or with the eggs. This almost always, provided the technique is correct, would ensure fertilization despite having poor semen parameters. And these are cases where ICSI is definitely preferred over IVF. In IVF, the basic concept is that the most healthy sperm would naturally go and fertilize the oocyte. That means we are dependent on nature to create fertilization in this procedure. Hence, when IVF is preferred for a particular couple, it is usually when the egg parameters have already been assessed and seem to be normal, and the sperm parameters have also been assessed and seem to be normal. It is also important to note that IVF could be a very good option, especially when the couples are of a younger age group as against an elderly age group. So if you were to listen to one advice or one strong point which I would like to convey to all couples who are planning to undergo assisted reproduction, is one thing. Remember, unfortunately, in this treatment, a doctor is trying to compete against nature. And in this procedure, it may or may not be certain that you might end up with a successful pregnancy. Because broadly speaking, despite the best efforts which humans are trying to put inside this treatment, the average success rate of this treatment over a broad age group remains to be approximately 30 to 40%. And that's why it's very important for a couple to be mentally prepared. It's unfortunately not like doing a digital marketing or a digital shopping where you may pay 1 lakh rupees and you will get something that you really wanted. Here, you might pay 1 lakh rupees, you might do the entire procedure on your body, and at the end of it, you might not get what you wanted. And in such situations, it is very, very important for the couples to carry forward this treatment without losing any hope. Because at the end of this treatment, it could be one attempt, it could be two attempts, it could be three attempts, or probably even more based on your particular complications. This is one of the best scientifically proven treatment which has stood the test of time again and again and again. And this is one way in which you will be able to achieve your dream of having a successful parenthood.